Topaz Video Enhance software uses AI to upscale original footage, and that's up to 8K. But did you know that you can also extract a sharp photo from video footage and have that at results up to 8K? But are these results worth the effort? Well, you'll see in this video. It stands to reason that footage with good original detail and sharpness will give you a much better result than footage that has a soft focus or a lower bitrate. So what will the results for a 720p video footage look like as a still extracted image? Again, I'll show you in this video. I'm Bruce McBride and I can provide one-on-one personal tuition over the internet. Click the link below, trainingfinalcutpro.com. And if you haven't done so already, please like, subscribe and press the bell. You need to know the limitations of your footage. We'll look at 720p videos, highly compressed, as well as 1080p footage, and see the results compared when we look at them at the same size when viewed in a 27-inch monitor. Anyway, let's jump into the Topaz software and try out the different settings. And if you'd like an overview of the software in its entirety, click the I above. First, I'll take a reasonably clear video, 1080p, that's 1920 by 1080, and extract an 8K still image. And once I've shown you the process and you've looked at the results, I'll also extract a 4K footage. And finally, I'll extract a photo from a 720p video, and we'll look at that both at 4 and 8K. The actual mechanics of extracting a single image are fairly simple. All you need to do is to find the frame that you want to extract, and then you would select the left-hand scissors and then move one frame to the right and select the right-hand scissors. And now you can see here you have chosen two frames, 3.5 and 3.6. But the decision comes as to what you want to upscale to. Now we can go to 4K, and this is a 1920 image, and if we go to 4K, we're going to go up 200%. And then the other decision is what of the AI models you want to use, and the HQ ones are best in this situation, and we'll use the Gaia for this selection. And then you want to decide on how you want your export to be or how it's to be saved. And my suggestion is to go to the 16-bit uncompressed because you're only actually saving two frames, so it doesn't take much time to do this. So once that's selected there, you can then now preview this by coming up to the preview window. And on the left is the original frame. And on the right is what the extracted image will look like. We can stop that there and just select a frame. You can see that it's clearly a better image on the right-hand side. If we look at the different sizes in the preview, you can see those detailed, particularly in the glass images, also around the edges of the roses here. And you can move that around and check the different detail. And you're getting a slightly better detail, and you've also increased the size of the image to 200%. So what do we need to do from here? We simply stop this process and making sure that this is the clip that we've got selected. We've already selected the two frames, so we can ask that to be processed now. And that happens fairly quickly because we've only in fact saved two TIFF images to the Finder. And we could look at those in a minute and compare them in the Finder. So we've taken a 4K image. Now let's take an 8K image and see how that looks in comparison. So coming up to the preview here, and we'll zoom in both images. There's the original on the left. Just stop the preview. Here is the upscaled on the right, and again it's got a better feel about it. Zoom in a little, then you can see there's certainly extra detail in the glass there. So this is a 400% increase, and it looks like it will give you a much better still image at the end of the day. So let's stop that and we'll process this one, and now we'll have a look at them in the Finder. And these are the two images showing in preview in the Finder. They've been zoomed in. That's the 4K image on the left and the 8K image on the right. So if we fill the screen with these now, that's the 8K image there. And if we bring in the 4K image and the 8K image. So you can see we've got a considerably larger image in the 8K version, but with the similar amount of detail. So let's look at the 720p image, and that's currently 1280 by 720, and I'm going to upscale that to 4K, which is a 300% increase in size. We'll use the Gaia HQ, and again, we'll select our position. We'll select the right-hand scissors at that point. We'll move one frame to the left and select the left-hand scissors. So those are the two frames that we've selected. I've done a preview. Let's stop that preview. We'll look at the different sizes. There's the original at the original size. There's the original zoomed in. Here's the upscaled version. So you can see that there's quite a lot of detail increase, and particularly around these sharp edges. And if we really take it up, then you can see the difference between the original there and the upscaled version here. So all we need to do now is to make sure we've got the right clip selected, process that video, and it processes fairly quickly because it's only saving two frames. This time we'll take it up to 8K, so it's 600% increase here, and we'll look at the preview. Now let's just select one frame in that. And there's the original, and here is the upscaled version. So it's picked up a lot of unwanted detail there. I don't think that we want to have the skin showing this way. So it looks like 4K is the answer for a 720p original image. And just to confirm that, these are now the two images showing in the Finder. They're in preview. And if we look at those sharper edges over here, this is in the 4K image. And if we look them over here, some of the detail is over enhanced in that portion. And if we look at the skin tones, then they're definitely over enhanced in the 8K. So this just proves that the 4K version is giving you a better result. So I hope that gives you some idea not only of how to extract a still image, but what sort of results you'll expect to get. Thank you for watching the video. If you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new videos every Sunday.